Fuller was always concerned with housing. He thought housing industry should be a service industry. Fuller called construction industry as a crafty and rough industry and regarded it as an 18th century skill that was still inappropriate in an industrial society. In the summer of 1940, Fuller and his friend were driving through Missouri where Mark Twain lived. Fuller noticed in wheat fields a row of galvanized steel bins. He was struck by the ease which with these could be turned into fireproof, livable huts. Nobody had thought of them as houses before. Fuller told his friend this was the most effective engineering unit for a small prefabricated house. That bin would provide enough room to house a small family at a cost of less than $1 per square foot with fireproof construction, and that was 80% below the cost in construction industry. Soon his friend agreed to put money into Fuller's idea. After the World War II, there was shortage of housing in US, and Fuller was one of the people who wanted to solve the problem. This Dymaxion deployment unit was successor of Dymaxion House. It was to be produced using factories, workers, and technologies that had produced World War II aircraft. Investors gave Fuller enough money to build a prototype. It seemed like he was about to pioneer a whole new industry. People wrote letters to Fuller displaying their interest in his newly built design of home. Fuller kept iterating the design, and stockholders were getting impatient, asking him to start producing them. He had still changes he wanted to make. He had 35,000 people sending in checks demanding the house, but Fuller's perfectionism did not let him start producing the houses on a larger scale. But when he realized that he was not going to get any more financing unless he surrendered all his control over manufacturing and design, he pulled the rug under his feet and went home because he didn't want further capitalism required under those conditions. It all came to a nasty fight, and he stood on his ground firmly, and company went bankrupt. One of the very interesting incidents mentionable about Fuller's perfectionism is that Calvin Tompkins worked on a profile of Fuller in New Yorker in 1965.
I worked on a profile for the New Yorker magazine of Bucky in 65. The checking department got hold of it about 3 weeks before it was supposed to run. And by that time, Bucky was off. I think he was in New Zealand at the time. And they reached him by telephone. And the checking department at the New Yorker is quite accustomed to spending a long time checking facts, but in this was unprecedented in their experience, because they were on the phone to New Zealand with Bucky for something like 17 hours, because he wanted to go over every single fact.
Bucky.
Only two prototypes of Dymaxion deployment units were ever produced. As for one and only Wichita House, which was a hybridized version of the two prototypes designs by Fuller, one of the investors bought it and reassembled it across town. His family lived there for 20 years. After failure of Dymaxion deployment units, Fuller had to reconsider his life. He was struggling, there was no academic institute that would accept him. But in 1948, Black Mountain College was looking for an architect for his summer program. They couldn't find one, so they hired Buckminster Fuller. The place Fuller was going had no real classes, no curriculum, no real grades, nothing but a place where people used to congregate. Fuller came there with his intention of building giant geodesic domes, and soon started his own experimentations with students. In first attempt, the thing immediately collapsed. Instead of being unhappy, he said he learned from his failure. Like always, he was dreaming with ambition, but there was a larger purpose behind the things he was doing. He said in conversation with a student that it was perfectly conceivable that he would be able to provide housing for all the people of the world with this basic geodesic dome, which could be stored, stacked, and delivered and dropped from air into countries like India and Pakistan. Following year, Fuller returned to college. The initial geodesic dome model was built and it stayed. Soon Fuller became Johnny Apple of geodesic dome. Johnny Chapman, better known as Johnny Appleseed, was an American pioneer nurseryman who introduced apple trees to many states within the US. The dome was such a hit that Fuller started his own company, Geodesics Inc. His first customers were US Marines. August 1st, 1953, Fuller finally got his modern igloo flying after all. Soon his realm spread across the globe and endorsed by people from all walks of life.
Today there are almost 2,000 geodesic domes in 40 countries around the earth.
In 1967, Fuller was selected to build US Pavilion at World's Fair. In 1968, Fuller was awarded gold medal for architecture for 1968. He didn't particularly pay any interest whether he was an architect or not. His only aim was to use technology to benefit mankind, and doing so he made contributions that had artistic as well as engineering value. In late 1960s, Fuller proposed a system, the Dymaxion map, or world game as it is what called, for plotting resources, trends and scenarios essential for playing on spaceship Earth so things could be managed in the best possible way. In Fuller's terms, we are on board spaceship called Earth, and the illogic of 200 plus nations is all trying to steer spaceship in different directions, but the project was never realized on a global scale as he envisioned. His dream was so much ahead of his time. The last phase of Fuller's life mostly consisted of him lecturing around the world. Maybe out of realization that humanity was going to enjoy Earth altogether on equal level, or maybe that his geodesic domes were not going to be mass produced. Fuller died on 1st July 1983, 11 days before his 88th birthday. During the period leading up to his death, his wife was admitted in Los Angeles hospital dying of cancer. It was while visiting her that he exclaimed at a certain point, quote, "She's squeezing my hand," end quote. He then stood up, suffered a heartbreak, and died an hour later at age 87. His wife died 36 hours later. In his 1970 book, I Seem to Be a Worm, he wrote, quote, "I live on Earth at present, and I don't know what I am. I know that I'm not a category. I'm not a thing, a noun. I seem to be a verb, an evolutionary process, an integral function of the universe," end quote. Thank you so much for watching. Have a good one.
Once was a square with a romantic flair. Bones on the Kim Maiden light. In the move that ensued, he went factory nude. Me, Scropius, Corbu, and Wright.